Hey readers, welcome to the Nonfiction Shelf Series here on the Shelf Addiction Podcast. I'm your host, Tamara Ford, and if you'd like to chat with me about the book reviewed in this episode, you can find me on Twitter and Instagram at Shelf Addiction, or in the Facebook group Shelf Addiction Official. This series is where I feature one nonfiction title that I've read during the month. If you enjoy nonfiction and you'll want to keep informed of what I'll be discussing each month, and you can do that by subscribing to the Shelf Addiction newsletter. Before we get started, I want to share with you one of the ways to support Shelf Addiction. If you enjoy this show and the content that I produce, please share this podcast with someone that would enjoy it or on your favorite social media channel. All right, let's jump into it. In August, I completed Becoming by Michelle Obama, the former First Lady of the United States. It is also narrated by Michelle Obama. Published November 13, 2018 by Crown and Random House Audio, respectively. The hardcover came in at 426 pages, and the unabridged audiobook is 19 hours and 3 minutes. This really worked out for me because not only has this been on my TBR list since November of last year, but it was also my book club read for the last month. So the timing was perfect and the stars aligned, and I finally got the book done. First, I want to talk about some of the things that I liked in this book. I love that this book provided some lovely, fun, lively discussion with the group. Although in the end, the group was split on how they felt about the memoir, but nonetheless, we had a great conversation about the Obamas' history, their family life, her political life, her work life, her home life, you know, and her time in the White House. I also enjoyed that I got kind of a peek behind the curtain as far as the Secret Service and events at the White House. Not to mention, it was great to hear about her family life growing up and how important her parents and her brother are in her life, as well as other family members that had some influence. I also enjoyed Michelle's tone. I liked that while she was giving us some really fun and quirky anecdotes, she is the lady that she always will be. This is one great quote from the book that I wanted to share. There are many, but here's one that's short and sweet and really tells a lot about Michelle Obama. If you don't get out there and define yourself, you'll be quickly and inaccurately defined by others. I related to that on so many levels. And I also related to her in the way that I understand her personality. So, for example, we learn and we see, we know this. If you're, you know, aware of Barack Obama at all, he is very charismatic, very much so. Same for her brother. You know, she shares with us how charismatic he was, and everyone loves her brother. And she had to work a little bit harder. She's not a naturally charismatic person. And I feel like I really relate to that on a lot of levels. I'm very nice. I'm very fun. I have a lot to offer and a lot to share, but I'm not the person when I walk in the room, everyone says, "Hey, Tamara, come over here. Hey, Tamara, how you doing?" That's not me. I'm not naturally charismatic, although I wish I were. I really love that she was able to attain what she was and have strong friendships and family bonds and, you know, lead teams of people in a way that was very effective. But yet she didn't have to be the star of the show, so to speak. Not to say that charismatic people don't work, just refreshing to see someone get how far she got with her own personality that wasn't necessarily the brightest star in the room. I also like that Michelle had to work really hard, and she says over and over again, like, the harder I worked, you know, I could get the same thing. I just had to work a little harder. And that's okay too. And I can appreciate that. Now, as you know, I always recommend memoirs if the author is reading them. I say this time and time again, and that holds true even in this case. When it comes to the drawbacks, Michelle's pacing of the audiobook was pretty slow for me. I think she has a natural cadence that's just a little slower, but it wasn't that big of a deal. I just sped up the playback, I believe, to 1.5 to make it comfortable to my ears. She comes through as a very positive, forthright, and sincere person, and I believe that her own voice reading her story really lent itself well to that. Another drawback to me was the slow start of the book. It took about 45% before I felt vested in the book. When Michelle shares how her and Barack met, their relationship, and of course his journey through the ranks to the presidency and how that affected her and her children, those parts really pulled me in, and unfortunately it took about 40% to get there. I rated this audiobook 4 out of 5 bookmarks. I did enjoy it, and I definitely recommend it. If you enjoy memoirs, or even if you aren't a quote-unquote fan of Michelle Obama, you'll still learn some interesting things about her family, career, and marriage. If you've read or listened to this title, be sure to find me on Facebook in the Shelf Addiction Official group, and let's talk about it there. I'm going to end things here. Until next time, happy reading. Take care, everyone.
If you enjoyed today's book chat episode and would like to show your support, there are a few things you can do. Head on over to Apple Podcasts and leave a positive 5-star review. You can follow me on Twitter at Shelf Addiction. Most importantly, you can share this podcast with friends and family that enjoy all things bookish, including author interviews. Thank you for listening, and until next time, happy reading.